हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव अ डन एक्सरसाइज नंबर 5A, ओके, ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5 डिवीजन, एंड फर्दर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एक्सरसाइज नंबर 5B। सो आई होप यू एंजॉयिंग अवर मैथ्स लेक्चर एंड ऑल्सो प्रिपेयर विथ अ your semester exam. So students, now we are going to learn further exercise number 5B. But before starting our session, our exercise, let's check today's quote and then after we move on our session. So let's check here today's quote. The secret of is to do the common things uncommonly well. What all students? The secret of is to do the common things uncommonly well. Got my points, all students? Understood? So now let's check here what we are going to learn today. So students, today we are going to learn exercise number 5B. Okay, in last lecture, I hope you all are remember exercise number 5A we have done. What all students? I hope you all are remember exercise number 5B left. Okay, and 5A is done in last lecture. Okay, and last two lecture I sent it to a revision video, means again and again last previous exercise we are going to do. Got my point, students? So now we are going to the further exercise number 5B, question number 1. What all students? Question number 1 and question number 2, repeated subtraction, exercise number 5C. Okay, exercise number 5C. Then after exercise number 5C, after question number 2, 3, 4 and 5, we have completed in exercise number 5B. Understood all students? Got my point, my dear students? So students, today we are, again I repeat here, today we are going to learn exercise number 5B, question number 1 and question number 2, and repeated subtraction, exercise number 5C, question number 2, 3, 4 and 5. Understood? So now let's start here the exercise number 5B, question number 1. What is the question number 1, all students? Okay, I hope you all are remember which chapter we are going to do here. Here we are do the division. What? Division. Exercise number 5B, question number 1. Find out how many trays are needed. What? Find out how many trays are needed. Understood? Got my points, my dear students? Then after we move on question number 1. Okay, the question is what, all students? Question is, read here first and then after we discuss. Question number A. 15 glasses, comma, 5 glasses on a tray. Means what? How many glasses are here? 15. 5, 10 plus 5, 15. Okay, so 5 plus 5 plus 5 is equal to 15 glasses. Okay, 5 glasses on a tray. What all students? 5 glasses on a one tray. See this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is one red box is in the tray. One tray, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so 5 glasses on each tray. So now question is what? Let's check here. 15 in equal groups of 5 gives a 3 groups. Okay. 15 in equal groups of 5 gives a 3 groups. Got my point, all students? 15 in equal groups of 5 gives a 3 groups. Okay. So 15 divided by 5 is equal to 3. Means how can it possible? So the method of division, I hope you all are remember, 15 inside the box means is divided and 5 is our division. So in table number 5, 50 will become, yes or no students? Yes, in table number 5, 50 will become, but where? So we speak that time, so 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10 and 5 threes are 15. What? 5 threes are 15. So answer is what? 3. So how many groups made it here? 1, 2 and 3. See in front of us. See, 1 groups, 2 groups, 3 groups. Means 1 tray, 2 tray and 3 tray. So there are 3 trays are needed. Okay. See, 1 tray, 2 tray and 3 tray. So students, in 15 glass, 5 glasses, group of 5 glasses and 3 groups. Okay. 5 in equal groups of 5 gives us 3 groups. means 5 threes are 15. 3 is what our answer. So 3 trays are needed. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? I hope you all are remember, my dear students. So then after, let's check here. A second question. Second question is what? As like that, but same question. But a different strength of what? Different strength of glasses. So students, 12 glasses. Okay, on a first question number A in the 15 glasses and question number B in a 12 glasses. 12 glasses, glasses and 2 on tray. Okay, so how can we divide? So 12 in equal group of 2 is a 6 group. What? 12 in equal group of 2 is a 6 groups. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? Again, I repeat here, 12 glasses and we divide in equal group of 2. Okay, 12, we divide equal 12, divide into 2 groups. Okay, so 6 groups. Okay, so 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 6 are 12. So see here. 2, 6 are 12. So how many groups made it? 2. And each group has a 6 glasses. How many glasses? In each group has a 6 glasses. So 2 trays are needed. How many trays are needed? That 2 trays are needed. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? Okay. So now let's start a question number C. Let's check here the question number C and then after we move on further question number 2. So let's check here the question number 2. What is the question number C? Question number C is 14 glasses and 7 on a tray. What all students? 14 glasses and 7 on a tray. So 14 in equal groups of 7 is 2 groups and 14 divided by 7 is equal to 2 and 2 trays are needed. That only I explained, but now I explain briefly. Okay students, so what is a 14? 14 is our divided number and 7 is our division number. So students, let's check here. So in table number 7, 40 will become or not? Decide first, think, and then after you tell me. So in table number 7, 40 will become. Yes, obviously 7 in 14 will become. Okay, so table number 7 in a 40 will become, but where? 7 ones are 7 and 7 twos are 40. So 14 glass is divided into 2 equal groups. Okay, divide into 2 equal groups. 2 equal groups. So 2 groups are made there and 2 trays are needed. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? I hope you all are understood betterly. So my dear students, we are going the further. Now your further exercise is exercise number 5B, question number 2. Find out how many groups. Write the division fact for each. Exercise number 5B, question number 2. Find out how many groups. Write the division fact for each. It means what all students? I hope you all are understood. We have done the question number 1. As like the same question, we are going to do the further. But here a different question or sum. Okay, method is same students, but now we are move the further. Exercise number 5B, question number 2. Find out how many groups. Write the division fact for each. So students, now let's check here the question number 1. So students, question number 1 is as like that. 9 step in all. How many stamp? Here a stamp. Stamp ticket or stamp. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9. How many? 9. Okay. Here is 9 step in all. 3 in each group. See here. 1 group, 2 group on 3 group. So 1, 2 or 3 group is there. So in 3 groups, how many tickets? 9. Each group has a 3. Okay. So dash group. So how many groups here? 1, 2 and 3 groups. Okay. And then after 9 divided by 3. So students, let's check here in table number 3, 9 will become or not, if you are decide. Let's think now. So you think it in table number 3, 9 will become, but where you also decide? Yes. Okay. So in table number 3, 9 will become, but where? So now we speak 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. Understood? Got my point, dear students? So 9 step and 3 group. So each group has a 3 stem. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? I hope you all are understood betterly. Now we move on further. Question number B. Let's check here the question number B. Okay. Let's check here the question number B. What is the question number B? Question number B is 10 step in, 10 stems in all. Okay. How many stems are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or 10. There are 10 stems. There are 10 stems. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? So there are 10 stamp. So here we are divide into equal group. Okay, so we are divide into the equal group. So 10 step in all, 2 in each groups. What all students? 10 step in all, 2 in each groups. Okay, so how many groups here? 2 groups. Okay, 2 groups, but for answer is 5. So in table 10 divided by 2. So students, in table number 2, 10 will become or not? You decide first, you think, and then we do the sum. So in table number 2, 10 will become or not? Yes, 10 will become. But where? 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8, and 2 fives are 10. 2 5s are how many old students? 2 5s are 10. Understood, my dear students? Got my point? So 2 5s are 10. That's why each group has a 5 stamp paper. 5 stamp. Okay. Each group has 5 stamp. Understood, old students? So now let's check here. Okay. So now I hope you all are written with me and all sum these in your textbook. So no need to write in your fair book, but only these blanks you have to write. Okay, only these blanks you have to write it down. Got my point, my dear students? Okay, students, now we move on question number C. Okay, let's check here the question number C. Okay, here a stamp of the queen. Okay, how many stamp here? 24 stamp in all. Okay, 24 stamp in all. So students, 6 in each group. 6 in C. 1, 2, 3 and 4. How many groups are here? 4 groups. 1, 2, 3 and 4. How many groups are here, all students? Here there are 4 groups. 1 groups, 2 groups, 3 and 4. 4 groups are there. So 4 groups are there. So students, 6 in each group. What each group has? How many stamps? 6 stamps. Each group has 6 stamps. Okay, each group has 6 stamps. So students, in table number 6, 24 will become or not in each group? Sorry, in table number 6, 24 will become or not? Decide. In table number 6, 24 will become or not? Yes, 24 will be come, but where? 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18, and 6 fours are 24. So how many groups we are divide in equal? 4 groups. Okay, 6 stamp in divide in equal to a 4 groups. Understood? I hope you all are understood. And now students, we move on further a next topic. So next topic is what? Repeated subtraction. What? Repeated subtraction. Understood? Repeated subtraction. Got my point, my dear students? So now let's check here. So my dear students, our new topic is what? Our new topic is repeated subtraction. What? Our new topic is repeated subtraction. Okay, new topic is repeated subtraction. Equal grouping can also be shown as repeated subtraction. Example, Surveer has a 24 piece of the colored square. What? Surveer has 24 piece of the colored square to make a pattern. He keeps taking out a 6 piece at a time. Find out how many times 6 can be taken away from a 24. What all, my dear students? Here new topic is a repeated subtraction. Equal grouping can also be shown as repeated subtraction. What? Equal group means the same group can also be shown as a repeated subtraction. Understood? Equal grouping can also shown as a repeated subtraction. Got my point, my dear students? So equal group also can be shown as a repeated subtraction. Example, okay, it's example now. Okay, Surveer has a 24 piece of colored square. Okay, 4 piece of the colored square to make a pattern. He keeps taking out 6 a piece at a time. Means 24 minus 6. Okay, so find out how many times 6 can be taken out. How many times 6 fours are? How many also done? 6 fours are 24. 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. 6 threes are 18. And 6 fours are 24. Got my point, dear students? So how many times 6 can be taken away? 4 times. See, 1. 2, 3 and 4. How can it possible? So let's check here. 20, first of all, 24 minus 6 is equal to 18. Okay, 24 minus 6 is equal to 18. 18 minus 6 is equal to 12. 12 minus 6 is equal to 6. Understood? So 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 times 6 can be taken out. How many times? 4 times 6 can be taken away. Okay, I hope you all are understood betterly, my dear students. Now let's check again, what is a repeated subtraction? Repeated subtraction is what? Equal group means same group can also be shown as a repeated subtraction. Okay, repeated subtraction is what? Equal group can also be shown as a repeated subtraction. Got my point, my dear students? Okay, same group, equal group can also be shown as the repeated subtraction. Okay, now example here is 24 piece of color square to make a pattern. He keeps taking out of 6 piece at a time. Find out how many times 6 can be taken away. Understood, my dear students? It's your repeated subtraction example. Again, I repeat here, students. Surveer has 24 piece of a color. Surveer has 24 piece of the color to make a pattern. He keeps taking out a 6 at a time. Find out how many times 6 can be taken away from. Okay, it means a 24. So 6 fours are how many old students? 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. 6 threes are 18. And 6 fours are 24. So how many times? 4 times. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 times. 24 minus 6, 18 minus 6, 12 minus 6. Okay. So 6 is 4 times can be taken away from to the 24. Understood? Got my point, all students? I hope you all are understood betterly. Now let's check other. How can this? We have a subtract a 6 from 24 times. We have subtraction 6 from 24. How many times? 4 times. X like that. See, 1 time, 2 time, 3 time and 4 times. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. So 24 minus 6 we do how many times? 4 times. See, students, again I repeat here. 1, 2, 3 and 4. What exactly that? 24 minus 6 is 1 time done, 18 minus 6 1 time done, 20 minus 6 3 time done and 6 minus 6 is a 4 time. So 6, we have to subtract 6 minus 6. Okay, 6. How many times we taken away? Okay, 4 times. So that time we should be counted 4 times. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? I hope you all are understood betterly. Okay, students. So what to do? We have subtract 6 from 24. How many times? 4 times. In other words, there are 4 6 in the 24. This is the same as 24 divided by 6. What I am told you exactly in table number 6, 24 will become? Yes, 6 4 is 24, is like that. Okay, in other words, there are 4 6 in the 24. See here, 4 4 6. See, 1 times 6, 2nd times 6, 3rd times 6, 4 times 6. Okay, 4 times 6. 4 times 6 is called what, all students? 4 times 6 is called 4 times 6 in 24. Okay, that is the same as 24 divided by 6 is equal to 4. Okay, this is the same as 24 divided by 6 is equal to 4. So let's check here, students. In table number 6, 24 will become or not? In table number 6, 24 will become or not come? Yes, students, 24 will come on table number 6. But where? 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18, and 6 fours are 24. Okay, got my point, my dear students? And then use the right term. Okay, then what we are applying here, students? Here we are apply use the right terms. Okay, so right terms is how can it possible the right terms? The number to be divided is the divided. Okay, see, the number to be a divided is the divided. The number that we are dividing by, it's called the divisor. The number that we are dividing by is called the divisor. The answer is division, called the quotient, is the right term. Already we have learned this method, but again I repeat. Okay, that time we do the addition, division, and we got the answer. It called a what? Quotient. Okay, inside the box it's called a divided, and outside the box it's called a divisor. It's my own term and easy term to how to learn. Okay, it's our easy term. Okay, inside the box it's called a divided digit, outside the box it's called a divisor, and upside above the box, it means our main answer, it's called a quotient. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? I hope you all are understood betterly. Again, I repeat here, students. Use the right term, divided, divisor, and quotient. Is this all term you are identify this all a term? Okay, which term, all students? Divided digit, divisor digit, and quotient. Okay, so students, these all words are important in a division. Okay, this all terms are important in a division. Okay, so now students, I hope you all are understood, and now we move on a further topic. Okay, so let's check here further topic. Exploring division. What is exploring division? Exploring division, it's a dividing a number by one. What? Exploring digit means a dividing a number by one. Explore, we have to explore something. Okay, what is the meaning of explore? We have a explore something. Exploring division, it means, now I am telling you teach you by a example. Dividing a number by one. Example: Supriti paints in her free times. What? She paints in her free time. She has a 4 paint brushes. What? She has a 4 paint brushes. If each paint brush has to be dipped into a 1 bottle of paint. Okay, 1 bottle dipped into a 1 bottle of each. So how many bottles we she needed? So here how many brush? 1, 2, 3, 4 brushes. And how many colors bottle? 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 colored bottle. So students, 4 brushes and 4 color painted bottles. Put 4 put into the groups of 1, each will give a 4 groups. What? 4 put into the groups of 1, each will give a 4 groups. 4 divided by 1 is equal to 4. 4 divided by 1 means in 1 4s are 4 or 4 1s are 4, 1 4s are 4, as like that. Okay, each bottle has 1 brushes. How many brushes means exploring a division divided a number by 1. We have to divide it with number 1. Got my point, my dear students? Supriti will need a 4 bottles of paint. How many bottles she need? She need a 4 paints of bottle. Any number divided by a 1 gives the number itself as the quotient. What we got here? The answer 1. 1. Okay, here we got the answer. Any number divided by a 1 gives the number itself as the quotient. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? Okay, I hope you all are understood betterly. Now a second, okay? Dividing a number by itself. Dividing, okay, first what we are, see here we are dividing a number by 1, dividing a number by 1, and here, dividing a number by itself. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? So now is this all things are important for us and all things are used in our division. Okay, all things are important. So students, now here we are learn the dividing a number by itself. Example, Supriti has a 6 different shade of the blue paint. Okay, Supriti has a 6 a different shade of a blueprint. She want to keep them together in box that can hold the 6 bottles. What? They can hold a 6 bottles. Again I repeat here, Supriti has a 6 different shade of bottles. See, blue, light blue, green, dark blue, as like that, 6 shade of blue paint. She wants to keep them. What? She wants to keep them into a box together in box that can hold the 6 bottle. Okay, she wants to, it means that can hold a 6 bottle which together. So how many box does she need? Okay, 6 put into equal groups of 6, each gives a 1 group, means 6 ones are 6. In table number 6, 6 will become, yes, 6 ones are 6. Any number divided with 6, it's got a, its answer is itself. Understood? Got my point, my dear students? Answer. Supriti need a 1 box to keep her bottles of blue paint. What? Answer. Supriti need a 1 box to keep her bottles of blue paint. Any number divided by itself will give a 1 as the quotient. Understood? What I am telling you, you know very well. Okay, students. Again, I repeat the answer. Answer. Supriti need a 1 box to keep her bottles of blue paint. Okay, so answer is what? 1. Quotient is what, all students? Okay. I repeat here the terms of the division. Divided number is a 6. Divisor number is also 6. And quotient is 1. As like that, 6 ones are 6. What, all students? 6 ones are 6. So any number divided by itself will give a 1 as the quotient. What, all students? Any number divided by itself will give 1 as the quotient. Any number divided by itself will give 1 as the quotient. Got my point, my dear students? Understood? I hope you all are understood betterly. Okay, here students, here this is your chapter number 5, and after complete your chapter number 5, we are going to learn a chapter number 6. What? After the completing chapter number 5, we are going to move on chapter number 6. Got my point, my dear students? Understood, all students? Okay, thank you so much, all of you. Thank you, all students.